Now, you heard of virtual reality training for pilots and military. Now, what about painters? Yes, exciting stuff happening at the Pearl Harbor Naval Shipyard. Joining us this morning is a couple of instructors. So we have Testa Waikiki and Brandon Endel joining us as well. And he's going to give us a demonstration in a bit. But Testa, I'll start with you. Tell us about this trainer, this high technology stuff that's available for you guys and how it's being used today.
So basically, Pearl Harbor Naval Shipyard and the Preservation Shop invested money into trying to see on how we can kind of help along in training our new and inexperienced hires that come in. And we came along with this virtual spray, which is pretty much, it's like a 3D video game type realistic looking spraying abrasive blasting simulator.
Now this spraying, this painting is done on our vessels to keep our, you know, fleet fit to fight.
Exactly.
And we have some B-roll as well, I know that. But I want to ask you, Brandon, how, as we can see you folks doing it right here on the B-roll, in our video, but how it's really done here at home? You can show us in studio.
Basically, this is the headgear that you use. So whatever is projected on the goggles, you can see it on the screen.
So what you're seeing is what we're seeing on the screen here?
Yes.
Okay, and then walk us through what you would be doing.
Right now, we're going to calibrate it. The gun towards my height and my spray level, and
so you're controlling the spray gun.
Yes. Okay. I'm operating the spray gun, and Testa can actually see exactly what I'm doing.
So is two guys are working at the same time, Testa?
Exactly.
Yes.
Yeah. So this is what will happen in our classroom. Is Brandon would be like our new hire or whatnot, and while he's spraying, us as the instructors will be right here at the console.
Very interesting.
And then looking, and we can kind of change like the settings, go to a different view. We can even go to like see right here. So this is a view of blue being too little bit paint, green is good, red is too much paint.
So you can instruct him while he's doing it, hey, back off a little or change what you're doing.
Exactly. So we can correct
him,
we can fix him, way more efficient.
Okay, and a young, savvy generation of workers, I bet you they appreciate this as well.
They actually do.
They're so tech savvy as is.
Yes.
They embrace this concept.
Yes, very much.
How exciting is this for you guys who've been around the game for a little bit longer?
It's a change of scenery. I mean, it's different. I mean, I think most of us have been gamers before, but to apply it to our workplace, just to make it where keeping those ships fit to fight and being able to bring in new and innovative technology into the workplace, I mean, it's awesome.
How awesome is that? Brandon, is this the future?
Yes, this is the future. The shipyard commander wants to invest in this type of technology, and I believe we're going to move forward with it.
For yourself, same question. How exciting is it to... You've been around the game for a while to have this kind of technology at your hands.
Yes, it's very fun, and that's part of training. You want to make it fun for the students also. So very, very innovative, very fun. I'm glad we're doing what we're doing at the shipyard.
And I'm trust me, the world and America is glad at what you guys do. You know, the Pearl Harbor Naval Shipyard for years, one of the biggest employers of civilians, and It's important to stay with technology, not just what you folks do to keep our feet fit to fight, but it's important to stay with technology the whole time as
well. Yes,
very
much.
Right on. Guys, thank you very much, Brandon and Testa. Good to meet you both.
Thanks for you.
And again,
thanks
thank you for your great work, and thanks for explaining what's happening. Exciting news happening in our shipyard. I want to try it. I feel like I want to try it. All right. We have